Hi everyone, it's Carol here, the founder of the Sleep Success Academy. And in today's video, I wanted to talk about why we can't force sleep. Because when we do try to force sleep, it actually just makes it worse. And so that's what we're going to look at in this video today. But before we get there, I just wanted to give you a little bit of an update of upcoming dates. So on May 29th, which will be a Wednesday evening here in Atlantic Canada, where I live at 6 p.m., I'm going to do a free coaching call. I've named this free coaching call, Reclaim Your Sleep So You Can Reclaim Your Life. So I will put a link down below so that you can go sign up for this free coaching call. And that is just really to, we'll meet on Zoom, you come on. I do have some stuff I want to share, but I also want to give enough space for you to ask your question on what it is that you can do in order to reclaim your sleep. Because I know from myself, from my experience, from the clients I've worked with, and from the members of the Better Sleep community, that when we actually reclaim our sleep, life just changes and we can manage things that we can't when we're sleep deprived. So that's the goal with the free coaching call on May 29th. I hope you can join me. Now to talk about this concept of like forcing sleep. I'll say it this way, you can't force sleep, you have to support it. And that's what I want to talk about today. What does it look like to support our sleep? But first, let's do this little experiment, because when we're trying to force something, what will happen? So I want you to take your hand and I want you to make a fist. Now I'm going to want you to try to open it using your other hand. So I want you to go and force your hand open. And I know for me, what's happening is my hand is actually tightening. It's like squeezing tighter. So as I try to force my hand open, usually what happens is we go against it and it gets tighter. And so if you've had that experience, like try to force your hand open. And then after you do that, I want you to now really focus on your hand and what's happened. So when I squeeze tighter, I actually got some tension through my arm. My whole body got into it. So I got even tighter through my body. And so this represents us going to bed and trying to force our sleep. And we might force our sleep in telling ourselves or telling our ruminating mind to just stop it, right? Just stop thinking, just go to sleep. The more we tell it to stop thinking this, the more it's going to think, because we're actually trying to pry open our hand as we say, stop thinking. Another way we might force our sleep is trying to change our sleep schedule, but not really recognizing that it's not what is causing our sleep issue, but it's maybe our emotional well-being or our mindset. So we're trying to change a behavior, forcing a behavior to allow us to sleep better when we can't. Actually, it's not the reason for the, it's not the root cause actually of our sleep issues. So that's force. But when I said we can't force our sleep, we have to support it. And now I want you to do something else. I want you to come with your other hand and I want you to come in and support this hand, right? So this is the hand that is forced, it's shut, it's not opening. And I just want you to sit here. You can even close your eyes as you do this. And what happens when you're supporting with your other hand, this hand? Right away, the tension is releasing. All right, you can feel your hand, it wants to open maybe. Like right there, my nervous system just took a breath and said, yeah, like the support is here, right? And see how much easier it is to open your hand when you're supporting it as opposed to when you're trying to force it open. And so this concept comes back to our sleep. How can I support my sleep? How can I support myself in order for my body and my mind to know what sleep could be like if I just supported it? And how might it be easier than trying to force a sleep schedule change or trying to force my mind to stop ruminating when it actually has a purpose for ruminating? We're just not supporting it to let us know what it wants us to know. When I think about support, I'm always looking at the three components to better sleep. If you haven't heard me say this before, I'm sure you have if you've watched any other videos, we always look at three components in order to increase or even fix the quality of our sleep. So we have to look at our emotional well-being, our mindset, and our behaviors. A lot of people will start with behaviors first, trying to change their behaviors, but that's through force. And we can only do that for so long until it backfires on us. We're going to want to start by looking at our emotional well-being. So I always start there in all my programs. If you have purchased any of my programs, You'll notice that we start with emotional well-being. And what we mean in emotional well-being is our emotions, what do we feel, and the state of our nervous system. So really getting some nervous system education, understanding frustration, understanding overwhelm, understanding that what we do all day really activates our nervous system, which is okay because it's supposed to, but how can we teach your body to deactivate? What is our, then the second component is our mindset, right? Right away, our mind, our ruminating mind. What are our thoughts? Are our beliefs that are showing up? Is it a belief like, my God, there's no way I'm going to be able to sleep tonight. I'm too activated. And then what are the tools that you can help support your mind with to help it maybe express what it wants to express, maybe create different things in your life? Maybe you need to ask for support from other people to be able to manage your workload. Maybe it's actually needing to go on vacation, or maybe your mindset now is that I'll never be able to sleep. So adding some tapping on, even though my mind just won't stop at night. So there's a lot of tapping scripts. You can go through my YouTube channel. If you're feeling anxiety or frustration or any of those before bed, or even the fear of not sleeping, there's some videos for that. So you just scroll and find some tapping videos to tap along. So we've looked at the first component, which is our emotional well-being. We've looked at how we can support ourselves through our second component, which is our mindset. And then we go to the third component, which is our behaviors. And how might we be able to support our sleep instead of forcing our sleep? How might we be able to support our sleep according to the behaviors we do? So are we doing supportive behaviors for our sleep or unsupportive behaviors? So what might unsupportive behaviors look like? It's trying to go to bed too early. When our body is not ready for to sleep, or staying in bed later, even though we've been in bed 8 hours already, but they might've been really crummy hours of sleep, deciding that I'll stay in bed a few extra hours to catch up on sleep, but I'm actually depleting my sleep drive. And therefore I won't be able to build enough sleep drive for the next night. So knowing all this and understanding that our emotional well-being for most people is at the root cause of our sleep issues, and behaviors come last. So doing this exercise again, right? So if you're forcing your sleep and you're trying to get the sleep going, so how tight, how's the tension? But what happens when we go and we support it? It becomes so much easier. And so if you want to know more about how to support yourself, to support your sleep, that's what the Better Sleep Community is all about. So our next group actually starts the week before June 9th. So June 9th will be, or June 8th, actually Saturday, June 8th will be the first video release, 4 to 12 weeks. And then we'll start our group calls on that following Tuesday. I don't know the date offhand, but if Saturday's the 8th, 9th, 10th, the 11th, on Tuesday evening, we have a training call. And then on Thursday evening, we have a group coaching call, which is all about answering your questions and implementing the strategies that we're learning. So we do a lot of tapping together. And when you do purchase the Better Sleep Community, even though we're not starting till June, you get immediate access to Tapping 101. And Tapping 101 is where you will learn how to use tapping specifically for your sleep issues. And so I'm excited. We're on week 10, week 11. We're nearing the end of this cohort. And the cool thing is everybody that's in there right now, they get to come back to when we start on June 9th, because once you buy once, you're in it until you are able to get to the root cause of your sleep issues, that you are able to use your tools easily without needing support from me, because you will have your own support system built in. You'll have you'll be your own hand allowing your sleep to come back. So as a reminder, the free coaching call is coming up May 29th. And then we start a new cohort with the Better Sleep Community the week of June 8th, June 9th, but you can purchase right away and then start your journey right away with Tapping 101. And you also get to join the private Facebook group that I have just for the members who have purchased the program. And then you can ask your questions in there as you're going along as well. So you are supported, even though we don't start the Better Sleep Community till June 9th. So I'm excited. And if you have any questions on how forcing sleep doesn't actually work, like, I don't know if anybody who has forced sleep and been successful, but we support sleep and then we can be successful. So I'd love to hear your comments. I'd love to know if this video actually created any ahas in your mind, if it can create one small action that you can take in order to start looking at your emotional well-being, your mindset, and your behaviors to see how you can support yourself on your journey to better sleep. That's it.